Hello everyone, assalamu alaikum. So here we'll take a look how to use GetX to do routing a little bit different ways, two different ways. I want to explain it here very quickly. To be able to do that, first go ahead and install get package and then you should be good to go. And after that, come to your material app and wrap it around get, G-E-T. Our app would be using GetX for routing and make sure at the top you import get. Okay, now if we're going to restart our app and it would still work as you can see. And now I have actually two pages here. One is my home page and the other one is my sub page. Okay, so here I'm going to call sub page and then here I'll change the parameters name. Instead of my home, I would call it sub. And if I call them, restart it, and we'll see that it changes over here. So it means that it's working. Now, the very first different way of doing routing in GetX. Well, you could do one way. Now, here we would use a property which is called GetPages. And as you can see from the first one, it takes a list of GetPages, okay? So it takes a list of pages. And how does it take? It takes, use it, GetPage, this constructor, okay? Now over here, you need to send your route name as well as the corresponding page, okay? Now the route name in general starts with, most of the time you want just to have a slash. Now this slash refers to the home page, very first screen. And after that, you can pass any kind of screen to it. So in this case, I'm gonna pass my home page. Okay, now if I have this one, now I'm going to go ahead and run it, and it still work. Now you might wonder if this is this one causing this thing, but no, not really. So we'll go ahead and run it one more time, and we see that it still works. So with the slash, you can just mention your page name or screen name. Now, as we saw just now that we have another page, which is called a sub page. So we'll save it as we'll change it to sub. And here we'll also change the title to sub page and we'll save it. And then let's reload. So here, as you see, it changes. So the slash actually refers to the initial page and that should be your home page, okay? It doesn't matter which screen. So whatever you put, whatever screen you put for this slash, it would be there, okay? Now I'm going to put it back to my homepage. Now I'm going to copy this one. And right after this, I'm going to paste it over here. Now this time, instead of doing just slash, I'll call it first, or even actually I'll call it sub, okay? Now here, I'm going to change it to sub page. And then we'll see that here it changes to homepage. So what happens if you have a list of pages using GetPage, this one, in general, Flutter or GetX itself looks for the slash, the first single slash, not the slash with any kind of string. So whatever it finds, for that one, it finds the related page or screen from this one, okay? Now, somehow, say, I'm going to change this one. So here I'm going to call the second page, okay? Here I'm going to call the sub page. So I'll change it to sub and so that we know that actual change is taking place. Yeah, so we still see that here it becomes sub. So the idea is whenever you have a list of pages, whatever the first slash, the initial slash, so that related page would be your first or initial screen. Hopefully it makes sense, okay? So this is one way of working with GetX routing. But anyway, I'm going to change this one to home, all right? And over here, I'm going to change it to sub, okay? All right, so we'll run it one more time and we'll see, of course, not much change. Now here it became home page. So now this order doesn't really matter. You can put it at the top, which you should not because it doesn't look good. But now you'd go ahead and run it one more time and you still see that we refer to home page, which is this slash and the related screen or the page, okay? So it doesn't matter the order. The thing matters is this one, okay? All right, so that's the first thing. But of course, if you want to call this one later from this page, you just have to mention the route name and then you're good to go. Now this is one way to do it, we learned it. And there is another way to do it. So for that one, we'll just simply go ahead and comment it out. We don't need this section, okay? All right, and right after that, here we'll be using another property, which is called routes. Here, I'm going to copy this on the slash, and here I'll make a map. So slash What happens, routes is a map. As you can see, it has curly braces. So it has a key and a value pair, okay? So now over here, I'm going to copy this one over here first. Let's go ahead and copy this. And then I'm going to have to pass a context. Otherwise, if you don't pass context, it won't work, okay? And then we'll just simply remove this, actually. Okay, now let's go ahead and run it. Yeah, and we see that it works, okay? So if you don't want to do it like this, get pages, you feel like it's too much or not good looking for you, or if you personally don't prefer it, you can go like this. So you can also do similarly another key pair for this one. So here we'll do sub, and then here we'll pass context, okay? Now here we'll call it my homepage, okay? Now here simply I'll call my homepage. Now let's go ahead and save it, and we see that, okay, it still refers to the very first one. But what if I change it to my homepage, okay? Now, of course, here I'll change it to home, and then here we'll change it to subpage, okay? So we're going to switch them, and we'll see how it works. So here it's a sub, okay? All right. Okay, so it refers to my homepage, okay, and which is related to this one. So the idea is if you're going to use get material, so the order really doesn't matter. And if you're going to use this routes, once again, the order also doesn't matter. Okay, so either you can go this way or this way. It's up to you how you do that. But personally, I would say let's go ahead this way because it's, I guess it's more organized and more readable. Personally, I prefer that. Okay, anyway, so if you like this video, don't forget to subscribe and smash that like button. Thank you.